It was the darkest of days, the end of the longest week. Jesus, the one they had hoped would be the long-awaited Messiah, was dead. The women had watched him die that most horrible, cruel, excruciating, slow death of crucifixion. They had been there when his lifeless body was taken from the cross. They saw the new tomb of Joseph the Arimathean, where Jesus' body was hastily laid. That Friday sunset would mark the beginning of the very special Passover Sabbath. The women made plans to come back after the Sabbath on the first day of the week to add the rest of the spices and ointments to the shrouded corpse to counteract the stench of the decaying body of this one they had dearly loved. It was the most they could do, but it seemed so hopeless. And to make matters even worse, the authorities had posted a guard who would now be camped in front of that sealed tomb. But now, before dawn, while it was still dark, Mary of Magdala could wait no longer. In her sorrow, she set out to express her grief, to show her devotion, at least to his memory. She was dismayed that this Jesus, who had changed her life, was gone, dead, buried in the darkness of that sealed tomb. Would this darkness last forever?
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for coming to be our Savior, our Redeemer, our Lord and Master. Thank you for your great love that took you to the cross. But thank you for your majesty and your almighty power that defeated death and Satan and sin in the grave. You are alive, alive forevermore. May this Easter we rejoice in the fact and the history of the resurrection, but may it also change our lives as we trust in you to be King of Kings and Lord of Lords in our lives as well. We pray this in your wonderful, almighty name.